If I point the antenna in a direction where the frequency isn't, the chirp will get quieter. So we're able to actually locate people through triangulation using using the receiver to triangulate the transmitter, and then the chirp will increase the closer we get.
The participant wears the tracking, basically the tracking device. The receiver works off a series of like megahertz radio transmissions with specific channels, and that's how one device ultimately finds the other. Within the York Regional Police Search and Rescue Unit, we're at 100% for persons found using the Project Lifesaver program. I think awareness could be a bit of a factor there. Although we're partnered with the Alzheimer Society as well as the Autism Society, maybe the information isn't getting out there like it should be to make people aware this exists and what it's actually for. And out of the demographic that of persons afflicted by some sort of dementia or Alzheimer's or anything that would cause them to wander, Project Lifesaver specifically targets the most severe cases, the persons that need the help the most. And when we get one of these calls, it is right away an emergency call, and that's how we respond to it. So it's not a blanket like fix all problem for some people who may be experiencing lesser forms of dementia or autism. This is for the most severe cases. That could represent the lower number.